Today we are going to discuss about the pulse transfer function. Okay, so we know that in case of linear time invariant continuous time signal, what is a transfer function? Transfer function is nothing but the ratio of Laplace transform of output to the Laplace transform of input, taking all initial conditions are zero. Okay, so in case of Z transform, we use the term pulse transfer function instead of only transfer function. So what is pulse transfer function? Pulse transfer function relates Z transform of the output at the sampling instance to the Z transform of the sampled output. Okay. Sorry, there is a mistake. This should be input, okay? So pulse transfer function relates the Z transform of the output at the sampling instance to the Z transform of the sampling input. So when the same system is subjected to a sampled data or digital signal R star T, the corresponding block diagram is given by this diagram, okay? That is, we are given RT as an output whose Laplace transform be RS. After sampling, we get the sampled output, that is the R star T or R star S, which is given to a transfer function or the plant of a control system GS. And after that, we get the CT or CS. So we can say that the output of the system CS is nothing but GS into R star S. So from the above expression, that is CS is nothing but GS into R star S, we can see that this transfer function is containing two type of function. One is an analog component, which is GS, and analog, and another is the digital component, which is R star S. Okay, so this is very difficult to manipulate this type of system. So it is desirable to express the system characteristics by a transfer function which relates only the start function, or this is in this discrete or digital form, that is which relates R star T to C star T, which is given by a fictitious sampler output. Okay, this the output of GS. Here we take a fictitious output and we put here a sampler. After that we get C star T or C star S. Okay. Now, so how do we define this? So now we can express C star S is nothing but summation of k equals to 0 to infinity C of kt e to the power minus kts. Since C of kt is periodic, then C star S is nothing but 1 by T summation of n is equals to minus infinity to infinity C into S plus Jn omega S, with the condition is C0 is equals to 0. Okay. Similarly, we can find that R star S, what is the value of R star S? R star S is nothing but 1 by T summation of n equals to minus infinity to infinity R S J n omega S. Okay. So from here we can also say that G star S, after that calculating C star S and R star S, we can find out the value of G star S, which is called the pulse transfer function, is nothing but C star S by R star S. Okay. Now it is also called the start transfer function. So pulse transfer function is also called the start transfer function. Now, if we substitute S is equals to e to the power ts in the following in this expression, then we get Zz is nothing but Cz by Rz. Okay. So therefore, we can conclude that the pulse transfer function or Z transfer function characterizes the discrete data system responses only at sampling instance. That means T, 2T, 3T, 4T up to KT. The output information between the sampling instance is lost. Means between two sampling instance there are no output information is available. Since the input of discrete data system is described by output of the sampler, for all practical purposes the sampler can be simply ignored and the input can be regarded as R star T. So for calculation, to make the calculation simple, we neglect the sampler and we take the output input as directly. So we neglect this part, we take this R star T directly as an input. Okay, so now we are going for some example. So here the question is, obtain the pulse transfer function of the given system. Here we see that input x, original input is xs, and the pulse input or the start input mean after the sampler is x star s. After that we put a zero order hold for holding the signal. That means for to get the whole signal in the output. Okay, we know that the sampler, when we use the sampler, the output between two instances is lost, but when we use the whole circuit, the output in between sampling instances is not lost. Okay, then we put a put a transfer function 1 by s into s plus 1, and we considered these two blocks at GPS. After that we get the output CS. Now from the block diagram we can see that what is the value of GPS. GPS is nothing but CS by S star S. That means output by input, which is nothing but 1 minus e to the power minus s into 1 by s square s plus 1. Okay, so if we using the formulas of Z transform, and we actually this expression we derived in our previous example, so we get the value of GPZ equals to 1 minus z inverse z into e to the power minus t z plus 1 minus 2 e to the power minus t divided by z minus 1 square into z minus e to the power minus t. Okay, I omit the whole calculation here because for the time, but in if this example is come to your exam, so you have to do all the steps. Okay, so finally we get that GPZ is nothing but e to the power minus t z plus 1 minus 2 e to the power minus t divided by z square minus 1 plus e to the power minus t into z plus e to the power minus t. Now for the sampling time, t is equals to 1. If we take the sampling time, t is nothing but equals to 1 second. Replace the all t's by 1 and we get this final expression, that GPZ is nothing but 0.368z plus 0.264 divided by z square minus 1.368z plus 0.368. okay, now we have to find out the pulse transfer function of some element, means the cascaded elements. So here we see that this is the sampler is only in between two elements. Okay, but in the second figure we see that the sampler is in between two elements of the cascaded form. That means in the first figure, we see that the cascaded elements are separated by a sampler. These cascaded elements in the figure B, we see that the cascaded elements are separated by the sampler, and in the figure A, we see that the cascaded elements are not separated by the sampler. Okay, so for the figure 1, we can see that the pulse transfer function is nothing but G1, G2, Z. So what do you mean by G1, G2, Z? When actually G1Z into Z2Z, okay? So when there are two transfer functions which are cascaded but is not divided by a sampler, then it is represented as G1, G2Z, which is nothing but K by S plus A into S plus B, okay? Now, so this is the product of Z transform of G1S and G2S. So after that we get this formula, that Z transform of K by B minus A into A 1 by S plus A minus 1 by S plus B. Okay. So now we take the impulse response of the function. We take the inverse Laplace and we get G of KT is nothing but K by B minus A e to the power minus A KT minus e to the power minus B KT, okay? So, from the definitions, we can find out the GZ from this equation as follows, that G of Z is nothing but summation of K equals to 0 to infinity K by B minus A e to the power minus A K T minus e to the power B K T into Z to the power minus K. Okay. Now, if we take the first part, that is summation of K equals to 0 to infinity e to the power minus k a t into z to the power minus k. So we get this function, that is equals to 1 plus summation of k equals to 1 to infinity e to the power minus k a t z to the power minus k. That means if we put k equals to 0, we get 1 plus here the limit is k equals to 1 to infinity. Okay. After that, we get find out the value e to the power minus a t, 1 plus e to the power minus a t, z inverse into summation of k equals to 0 to infinity e to the power minus k a t, z to the power minus k. So from here, we get that summation of k equals to 0 to infinity e to the power minus k a t, z to the power minus k is nothing but 1 by 1 minus e to the power minus a t z inverse. Okay. Now substituting the value of this, and if we take the second part, that is summation of k equals to 0 to infinity e to the power minus b k t z to the power minus k, we get the result that 1 by 1, similar to the above, we get the same result at 1 by 1 minus e to the power minus b t z inverse. Okay. So we can, if we substitute these two values in the equation of ZZ, so we get that ZZ, that is equals to Z1, Z2, Z, which is nothing but K by B minus A into 1 by 1 minus e to the power minus A T Z inverse minus 1 by 1 minus e to the power minus B T Z inverse. That is equals to K by B minus A into Z into e to the power minus a t minus e to the power minus b t by z minus e to the power minus at z minus into z minus e to the power minus bt. Okay, so this is the transfer function of this. Okay, now we are going to find out the transfer function of this term. Means the cascaded elements are separated by a sampler. Then we find out the transfer pulse transfer function is g to z and g1 z and z2 z, which is a different z transform of, that is z transform of k by s plus a into z transform of k by s plus b. From here we get that k z square by e to the z minus e to the power minus a t into z minus e to the power minus b t. So from here we say, see that of the pulse transfer function of the 14a and figure 14a and 14b, means these two figures are not identical. So we can say that z1 z2 z is not equals to z1 z into z2 z. Okay, so one must carefully observe whether there exists a sampler between the cascaded elements or not. Now we are going to find out the pulse transfer function of a closed loop system. Here the error signal is sampled. Okay, so ES is nothing but RS minus CSHS. Okay, again CS is what? CS is nothing but GS into E star S. Okay, now what is ES now? ES is nothing but RS minus GSHS E star S. Okay, so ES is equals to RS minus GSHS E star S. If we now start both the functions, both the sides, so we get that E star S is nothing but GHS, GHS as they are in series and there is no sampler, that is GHS. That means if we take the pulse transformation in both the sides, what happened? Happen is E star S is nothing but R star S minus G H star S into E star S. Okay, so G, what is G H star S? G H star S is nothing but mod of G S H S whole star. Okay, so now we get that E star S is nothing but R star S by 1 plus GH star S. Okay, now what is the value of C star S? C star S is G star S E star S. Okay, we put the value of E star S here, we get C star S is equals to G star S R star S divided by 1 plus GH star S. So we can say that the pulse transform CZ is nothing but ZZ RZ by 1 plus GHZ. Okay, where GHZ is nothing but Z transform of GS into HS. Okay, now we have to obtain the Z transform of 1 by S into S plus 1. Okay, I have already discussed this in the previous example. So now XT is nothing but Laplace inverse into 1 by S into S plus 1. Okay, so Laplace transform of 1 by S minus 1 by S plus 1. So Z transform of XT is equals to XZ. From here we get that x t is nothing but 1 minus e to the power minus t. So z transform of 1t minus z transform of e to the power minus t, which is nothing but z by z minus 1 minus z by z e to the power minus t. Okay. So here we get z into 1 minus e to the power minus z by z minus 1 into z minus e to the power minus t. Okay. So now we have to obtain the pulse transfer function of the given system. This chapter is mainly related to mathematical example. Okay. Actually, from this chapter, mainly the maths will come in your exam. Theory part is less in this chapter. Okay. So from here we get GPS is nothing but CS by X star S, which is nothing but 1 minus e to the power minus s by s into s plus 1. So taking the result from the above question, we get that 1 by s into s plus 1. For this, it is comes that z into 1 minus e to the power minus t by z minus 1 into z minus e to the power minus t. For 1 minus e to the power minus s, we get 1 minus z inverse, okay? So after simplification, we directly get 1 minus e to the power minus t by z minus e to the power minus t. Now for sampling time t is equals to 1 second, if we put t equals to 1, we get that GPZ is nothing but 0.632 divided by z minus 0.368. Okay. Now obtain the another example is obtain the z transform of 1 by z square into s plus 1. Okay. So now by partial fraction, xt is equals to nothing but Laplace inverse of 1 by s square into 1 s plus 1. So we get Laplace inverse of 1 by s square. We get by partial fraction, that means by putting a by s plus b by a square plus c by s plus 1. After that, we get the value of a is equals to minus 1, b is equals to 1 and c equals to 1. After putting the value of a, b and c, we get 1 by s square minus 1 by s plus 1 by s plus 1. So after taking the Laplace inverse of 1 by s square minus 1 by s plus 1 by s plus 1, we get that the value of xt is equals to t minus 1 plus e to the power minus t of ut. Okay. So now, from the above equation, we can say that xz is nothing but z transform of t minus 1 plus e to the power minus t, which is equals to tz by z minus 1 whole square minus z by z minus 1 plus z by z minus e to the power minus capital T. So after simplifying this, we get the value of xz is nothing but z into e to the power minus tz plus 1 minus 2 e to the power minus t divided by z minus 1 square into z minus e to the power minus t. Okay. Now we are going to discuss about the stability test in the digital control system or discrete transfer function. Okay. So here we use the Judy's stability test. Okay. So what about the Judy's stability test? A stability criterion for discrete time system, which is simpler to the Routh-Hurwitz criterion and which we have learned in the control system 1. Okay, the RH criterion, and can be applied to the characteristics equation written as a function of z, is the Judy's stability test. Okay, so when we understand this by the example, it is clear to us. Okay, now let the characteristics equation of a discrete system be represented by qz is nothing but a n z to the power n plus a of n minus 1 z to the power n minus 1
plus dot 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 plus a2z square plus a1z plus az0 is equals to 0, okay? So, width must be sufficient and necessary and sufficient condition that an must be greater than 0, okay? It should not be negative or 0. The value of an must be greater than 0. The array of Judy stability test. We put the columns z1, z to the power 0, z to the power 1, z to the power 2, dot dot dot, z to the power n minus k, dot dot dot, z to the power n minus 1, dot up to z to the power n. Okay. So we put the value of a naught, z to the power 0 is replaced by a naught. A1, A2 up to n minus k, dot dot dot, a of n minus 1, an, okay. So, the next row is in reverse order of the previous row, okay. So, we put an, an minus 1, an minus 2, dot dot dot, ak, dot dot dot, a1, a0, okay. Now, third column is represented by b0, b1, b2, b of n minus k, b of n minus 1, and the next row is the reverse of the third row. Similarly, the fourth row is we take a measure that c0, c1, c2 up to cn minus k and replace this in, and the sixth row is the reverse of the previous row. So we do here similarly, and now we define what is b0, b1, okay? The elements of each of the even number rows are the element of the preceding row in reverse order, which I am already telling you, okay? And the elements of the odd numbered rows are given by what is the value of bk? Bk is nothing but a0 ak, a0 a of n minus k, an ak. That means the multiplication of this minus this. So b0 is nothing but a0, a1, b, an, and a of n minus 1, that means the k, okay? Now, what is ck? Ck is nothing but b0, b of n minus 1 minus k by b of n minus 1 bk. Now, what is dk? Dk is nothing but c0, c of n minus 2 minus k, c of n minus 2, ck. That, what are the necessary and sufficient conditions for Judy stability test? The necessary and sufficient conditions for the characteristics polynomial QZ to have no roots on or outside the unit circle in the Z plane with, we already told that an must be greater than 0 and are as follows. Q1 is greater than 0, minus 1 to the power n, Q of minus 1 is greater than 0, mod of a0 is less than mod of an, mod of, that is, we can say also the determinant. So, determinant of b0 must be greater than determinant of b of n minus 1, determinant of c0 must be greater than determinant of cn minus 2, determinant of d0 must be greater than equals to determinant of b of n minus 2, determinant of m0 must be greater than determinant of m2. Procedure, what are the procedure to check the three conditions, that is q1 is greater than 0, minus 1 to the power n, q of minus 1 should be greater than equals to 0, and mod of a0 or determinant of a0 must be less than an. Stop, we can stop our procedure if any of these conditions are not satisfied. If this any of the conditions are not is not satisfied, then we stop there and stop our calculations here and said that the system are not stable. Okay. Number two, construct the array checking the conditions of equation 2 as each row is calculated. Okay. Stop if any conditions is not satisfied. It also may be noted that for a second order system, the array consists of only one row. For each additional order, two additional rows are added to the array. Okay. Now we have considered this closed loop system, and we have to find out the value of k, this k, for which the system is stable, and we find this using the Judy's stability criterion. Okay. So we have already find out the z transform of, that means dpz, pulse transfer function of this feedback control system. So we get the value of gz is nothing but e to the power minus tz plus 1 minus e to the 2 e to the power minus t divided by z square minus 1 minus e to the power minus t into z plus e to the power minus 2. Now for sampling time t equals to 1 second, we get g of hz. He has, this is an unity feedback, there is no change in the calculation, we just only put 1. So we get g of hz is equal to 3.68k into z plus 0.717 by z minus 1 into z minus 0.368. okay. Now for the closed loop system, characteristics polynomial is nothing but qz is equal to 1 plus ghz, which is equal to 1 plus the above equation. We get, find out that qz, finally we find out qz is nothing but z square plus 0.368k minus 1.368z plus 0.368 plus 0.264k. okay. So from here we can see that there is z to the power 0, z to the power 1 and z to the power 2. So we put z to the power 0, z to the power 1, z square. So all the z square means nothing but a 0, so we put here, then a 1, after that 1. Okay. From the here we can see that, and the reverse is 1, this and this. Okay. So from here we can see that the constraint, that is q of 1, is greater than 0. If we put q of, instead of z we put 1, so we get that this is greater than 0. So here 1 plus greater than 0, or k is greater than 0. And the second constraint is minus 1 square. Q of minus 1 is greater than 0. So what happened? Yes. Yes, we put that 1 minus this, put the value of z is equals to minus 1, nothing else. Okay. Here we put the value of z equals to plus 1, here we put the z equals to minus 1, okay. So we get that the value of k is less than 26.3, okay. So from this above condition constraints, we can again say that mod of a0 is less than a2. So from here we get the value of k is less than 2.393, okay, which is less than k equals to 26.3. So the system is stable if and only if the k lies between 0 and 2.393. okay. Now there is another example. Determine the impulse z transform f of kt in a closed loop form for this function for all k is greater than 0. Okay. So fz is nothing but this, and we factorize this polynomial like z minus 1 square into z minus 2. Okay. Now taking the partial fraction, we get that this term becomes 20 by z minus 2 plus minus 9 by z minus 1 plus minus 2 by z minus 1 and whole square. Now if we take the inverse Z transform, so we get Fk. Fk is equals to Z inverse of minus 10, 20 by Z minus 2 plus minus 9 by Z minus 1 plus minus 2 by Z minus 1 square. So we multiply these 10 into 20 minus 200 Z inverse of 1 by Z minus 2, 90 minus minus plus 90 Z inverse 1 by Z minus 1 minus minus plus 20 Z inverse of 1 by Z minus 1 square. So if we take this, this is the value of 2 to the power k minus 1, 1 minus 1 to the power k minus 1, this is 1 to the power k minus 2, okay. Now, if we simplify this, we get the value is minus 200, 2 to the power k minus 1 plus 70 after calculating this, 1 k minus 1 plus 1 to the power k minus 1 plus 20 k into 1 to the power k minus 1. Okay. So, today we are stopped here. Okay. Have you any questions?